One moment I was planning my life, and then the next moment I ended up fighting for my life. I had a cyst and I went to my regular gynecologist to get it removed, and it turned out to be too big to remove in-house. So she had to schedule surgery for it, and it was during surgery that was supposed to be 30 minutes, it ended up being hours. And I just remember waking up and the room was silent, and my family kept asking me, you know, have you seen the doctor? Have you talked to the doctor? So I immediately knew something was wrong. That's when she came in and she explained, well, during the removal, she did notice it was some cancerous tissue. And then everything in the room, it fell silent. Like I blocked everything out as, you know, tears began to roll down my face. Third time, this time it's kind of been a mixture of the first and second time. I have my bad days where everything kind of hurts at one point. And then I have my good days where I can hardly tell that I went to chemo, but it does get rough. I had radiation the second time every single day of the week for the whole month of May during the summer, and it hurt. It hurt to the point where, you know, my skin was raw. I take the normal precautions, you know, you wear a mask. I feel like my hands are, you know, like super dry from the Germex and everything, constantly putting it on between sessions. I tell my cheerleaders all the time, unless you show up, it's hard to make an impact. So they keep me going each and every day. I absolutely love what I do as a cheer coach. They keep me going. The faculty and staff at CHS keep me going. I love to be here. My family keeps me going.
I don't think that she has cancer. I think that literally she's been put on this planet to inspire the rest of us to realize that once we live out our dreams, that nothing can stop us. Literally, she's one of the strongest people I know, and she reminds me so much of my mom. I lost my mom to cancer about 5 years ago, and just seeing the strength that she has and never complaining, always offering another hand to help someone else out the way, like, that's who Jessica Veazey is, and that's what the students love about her.
I didn't know she had cancer until we had our parent meeting together, and she, you know, introduced herself as our new coach, and then she told us that she does have cancer, but that doesn't stop her. And so that message to us, basically she was telling us that she doesn't take excuses, and neither should we. And so that ultimately set the tone of our cheer squad. And so it's days where we may be tired or we may be sore, but we remember that she comes and she helps us and she fights for us, and so we owe it to her to do the same thing. And so there's no room for complaints. There's no room for giving up. We always remember just to go a little bit further as she does for us each and every day so that we can be the best cheer squad that we can possibly be.
I always make sure to give back. That's why I'm still in my cheerleaders. Yes, we are here to support the team in terms of school spirit, but we also need to remember and learn how to give back to the community. So each year we do a fundraiser for St. Jude Children's Hospital and the Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation. And we normally have a gold night, and the cheerleaders have all gold accessories. And then we have a pink out night, which is coming up soon, and they have all pink accessories. So we sell anything from bracelets to t-shirts to pom-poms, anything that the fans may be interested in to raise money. And we try to give at least $500 minimum each year.